Hey, YouTube, got up this morning and had a comment on the Gevey sim video demonstration of somebody saying that they didn't believe it was the actual video, that we edited it. So we're going to upload the original unedited video. Please ignore the pop-ups that come on the screen. That is exactly what we edited out. So from beginning to end, the demonstration of the SIM card activating the phone. Enjoy. Hey YouTube, DJ Mick here, reporting from Mike's Place. We've got a Gevey review demonstration of the card itself actually unlocking an iPhone 4. Now, we've had a customer contact us and explain that they've had issues with not finding videos online of seeing the card actually work, where they've got an unlocked phone, the SIM card it fails when put into the phone, and unlocks when used with the Gevey SIM. So that is what we're going to review today. First of all, I'll turn the iPhone 4 on. Also, I will show you here, we've got a bell focus here on me. I had to notch it, obviously, from our previous demonstration. It's in the video, but you can see bell vividly there. And there's some numbers. And there's the SIM. So, yeah. First, we'll put it into the phone with the without the Gevey SIM card and show you that the SIM card will actually fail. Once we've done that, we'll put it in with the Gevey SIM card. Let's show you the phone information. Currently, we have no SIM. We are on version 4.3.1, and this Gevey SIM also works 4.3.2. Carrier 10.0, this is a Telus phone, but because I have been putting the Gevey and the Bell card, it just went to carrier. And it is an iPhone 4 here, MC603C. So, once we take this go back to the home screen. Insert my SIM card into the tray and put it into the phone. So I just got one signal bar. Now this video will be unedited. Excuse the roughness. I can't take out my errors on speech and mix in some cool transitions, unfortunately. So we're going to be winging it the old style way without all the cool tools of being able to edit video. Just to show you complete demonstration of the Gevey SIM card actually working. Now I know when you first put a SIM card that's not compatible, it could sit here forever on a single signal bar. So I'm just going to eject it here and then just put it back in. SIM failure. Invalid SIM. Well, doesn't that suck? Well, I guess I'll have to call Mike at Mike's Place and get him to ship me a Gevey SIM card. What we'll do now is remove it from the tray. Remember, we had it notched there, so that it is not in the way of the chip that does the unlock process, and make sure it's a good snug fit and it's snapped into the tray really well, because it is a tight fit into the phone with everything. So now once it's stacked in there, we're going to power off the phone. Power the phone back on. Mm-hmm. Again, sorry for the crudeness of this video. Put some background music in maybe or something. So here we go. No card inserted. The corner says no SIM. Remember, this is a Telus phone we're working with. Now, first thing we're going to do is once we slide this in, we don't do anything and we physically wait for the phone to tell us an error message or an accept screen where we can actually click accept. You can see it already went to a single bar on us and it says searching. But you don't do anything until that accept screen comes up. And there it is. So now we click accept, go to our phone, wait for a single signal bar. There it is. I don't know if you can see that. Then type 112. Once you hit call, you only want to wait 2 seconds. 1-1000, 2-1000, and hang up. Call will end, and once it says call ended, close out of your phone and go into settings and turn on your airplane mode to on. Once that's on, you don't do anything. You wait for the next message. If you go straight to turning this back off, the airplane mode, you will not be successful in unlocking the phone. And this process has taken upwards of 2 minutes, but we'll hope here that it doesn't take that long. If it does, you can, the glory of fast forward, you can skip up and check out the message ahead of the video. Oh, there, that was quick. So no SIM card inserted is the message we get. Press OK, and then turn airplane mode off. SIM failure is the next message, and as you can see in the corner, it said invalid SIM. Now, obviously, the SIM card's coming to life. And I'm getting a whole pile of notifications. Wow. Alright. Just a nice demonstration of how the SIM card came to life. Oh, a nice little live message from Bell. Thanks, Bell. And also, thanks for locking my phone, you providers that want to keep my money with you. Look at that! 4 bars on Bell. Ha! You gotta love it. Well, this demonstration was here only at Mike's Place. Give me thumbs up if you liked the video. Leave comments below. And don't forget to subscribe, because we do our best to try and get some updated videos of most requested things online. And God bless, and peace out.